Hi, welcome to this Packet Tracer tutorial. Today I will show you how to set up a basic network in Cisco Packet Tracer. We will start with a local area network and move on up from there. If you don't have CPT installed, you can download it from the link in the description. Let's get started. First, we add a generic switch to our workspace. The switch will route packets within the local network. This is an Ethernet switch. CPT also has a wireless switch. I'll show that in a future video. Now, we place a few end devices and connect them to our switch using the cable tool. Let's assign IP addresses to each PC by clicking on them and using its interface. This network will be 192.168.0.0 with the subnet mask of 255.255.255.0. So, enter 192.168.0.3 onwards. I am not using the 0.1 and 0.2 as I will use them for a server and routing later in the video. Once that's done, let's test our network. Click the simple PDU tool and select a source and a destination. You can see it was successful in the tab in the bottom right corner. If you want to see the step-by-step process, you can switch to the simulation screen. There, you can see the movement of each packet and all additional packets being exchanged for maintenance purposes. You can also see the content of each packet by clicking on them like so. Now we have a basic LAN complete, but it's pointless unless you can communicate with other networks. So we move on to the next section of the tutorial, adding routers and configuring them to route our packets. We will configure them using the command line interface as real routers don't have GUIs. Before I start with routers, I will automate the IP assignment using a DHCP server. Add a server to the workspace and configure the DHCP service. We add this server to our network and switch the PCs to DHCP mode so they can ask the server for IP addresses and gateways. That's done. Let's move on to the routers. I add a generic router and add a few more serial ports so I can connect to other routers later on. Most routers are interconnected using serial ports. You will need to turn your router off before adding or removing any ports. Moving on to configuring the router in the CLI tab, I will describe the commands as I type them. EN will switch me to enable mode. Config T will switch to the configure mode. Interface FA 0/0 will switch to the interface I want to configure. We enter IP address, then the IP address, then its subnet mask, which will set the IP address of the interface. No shutdown will turn on the interface. You can press tab to auto-complete commands. If you ever have a doubt about the commands, you can press the question mark key for help prompts. Enter exit to leave the current mode. We will be repeating this process for each interface and for each router we add to the network. Now we add a few more networks in super speed using the magic of editing. Now we need to configure our routers to actually route packets between our LANs. For that, we will set up OSPF in each of our routers. More information on OSPF is linked in the description. I will explain the commands as I type them. Enable, then config T, router OSPF0, which will set up the OSPF service. For each network that is connected to our router, we enter the commands network, the IP network, a wildcard mask, area 0. For example, for the initial network, we write network 192.168.0.0 space 0.0.0.255 area 0. We keep area as 0 as all our networks are in the same routing area. We repeat this for each router. Now we fast forward time for the routers to communicate and set up their routing tables. Use the info tool to see their routing tables. Now we simulate the routing of packets in simulation mode. Select a source and destination using the simple PDO tool. As you can see, it's working perfectly. Next, we secure our router by adding passwords on the enable mode and telnet lines. Enable password Cisco. Username, password, then we move on to the line interface, line VTY 0 space 4, login local, now we test if the password is configured correctly. Go to any PC and open its command line interface. type telnet and the IP address of the router. There we see a prompt for username and password. After successfully entering it, we get the router prompt. It's working perfectly. That concludes our video. All relevant site topics have been included in the description. If you have any questions or feedback, do post them in the comments. Thank you.